Good morning, everybody. Good morning, everybody. So, yeah, yesterday it hit me about the more gallons and Lyme disease and all the new exotic diseases that are out there that have not been mainstreamed, potentially even PMDD, because PMDD was not something recognizable way back in the 90s, 2000s. And then I know my condition with PMDD, even though it wasn't diagnosed, but I knew all of the symptoms were not something that were normal. I knew that I was dealing with something that I couldn't put my finger on, and that's what led me to then the Jilly Juice protocol. So all these new diseases out there, you have to wonder where the hell are they coming from? When you're watching TV, you're watching TLC. Like I watch TLC and I'm watching like My 600-Pound Life. I'm watching Hoarding on A&E. Sometimes on TLC, they have, what is it, Doctor something, Pimple Popper, whatever. And I'm just like, what is the deal with all of these medical shows that are basically turning into entertainment? And then I'm watching the Netflix documentaries on Love on the Spectrum, and I'm like, oh my God, you know? And it's just like, the genetic engineering has become such a money-making venture that, my God, why would the medical holistic industry out themselves when there's so much money in genetically modifying, genetically engineering a human? Now, genetically modifying food, I'm not worried about because, yes, those intentions in the genetically modified food, when you do the Jilly Juice, you can purge all that stuff out, not a big deal, you'll still get nutritional benefit. But when you genetically modify a human, now that human has to go through a healing process to morph back to what they were originally intended, back to the innate immune system before it was genetically engineered through monoclonal antibodies. So if you want to know what is behind all the different Morgellons, if you actually look at the symptoms of Morgellons and read what PubMed or Medical News Today or even WebMD or any of the other journals of medicine, they will say that there's an itching, you know, with Morgellons. There's an itching. There's little fibers that come out of your body. When people test for parasitic infections, they come up negative. Okay, they know that parasites are part of your microbiome, and it's not anything to be afraid of. It's part of your microbiome. But what they do say, it is a type of bacterial type of issue. So what would cause a bacteria to have an infection to then create sores and itching and feeling of the creepy crawlies under your skin? Well, it would make sense when there is a bioengineered monoclonal antibody that is attacking your cells under your skin, causing then inflammation where the body now is trying to reproduce new cells, heal. And you're feeling it as if, like, remember, like when you cut yourself and you're itching, right? And that's the healing process that you know about when you were a kid and you had a Band-Aid, and then after you take the Band-Aid off, you're itching, and then the wound heals and everything is great. Well, imagine having monoclonal antibodies continuously attacking you every single day. You can call it nanoparticles, you can call it, you know, whatever you want, but it's where these monoclonal antibodies are engineered to go after specific cells and proteins in your body. And I don't know what exactly the programming is, and that's biotech's secret that they're not going to tell you. So you're just feeling the effects of these monoclonal antibodies that are bioengineered to go after parts of your skin cells, and then you're feeling a continuous evolution process, like your body's trying to evolve, and then you are not giving it what it needs because you have no idea how to give it what it needs. So then guess what? That's a chronic condition. And these people feel like they're going insane. Like I'm reading like stuff around the Morgellons group, and that was like way back in the beginning when I did the Jilly Juice. These Morgellons group were going like, oh my God, these little fibers, and the thing is the chemtrails and this and that, which, you know, I wouldn't be surprised that, yeah, antibodies, that have been bioengineered, could they live for a while or whatever on in I don't know, airplanes. I mean, that sounds so conspiracy related, but then the vaccine community and people that are vaccinated, there is antibodies, Rabs and Mabs, that are being infused in vaccines in the vaccine shed, and not everybody gets vaccinated. Some people do, some people don't, but people catch each other's antibodies, and then this is what precipitates then these different types of pandemics or exotic illnesses based upon your predispositions and all of that. So it's like, holy crap, holy crap. And I'm just like, and I'm looking at like, okay, so I'm reading this stuff about Morgellons and how these people, it's a bacterial thing. So then, yes, these antibodies are attacking your bacteria. That's what it is. They're attacking your bacteria. Your bacteria is about maybe 2 or 3% of your body. So you can have a couple pounds of bacteria because that's part of your microbiome. If you actually break down the microbiome, which is viruses, parasites, protozoa, protein, fungus, and bacteria, well, viruses are so prevalent. You can't get away from them. Everyone that's been exposed to a virus, you've been exposed. Either you test positive or negative, but you've been exposed. The positive and negative is based upon the algorithms of the person actually creating the test or administering the test, okay? But viruses are the first thing. That's the evolution. That is what controls the data in your system and keeps the upgrades going, okay? And the parasites are part of the microbiome, protozoa, proteins, fungus, bacteria, all of that. All of those are part of your microbiome. They all make up a certain percentage of your body. Okay, the proteins, the cells, and then you have the biochemistry. You have the fatty acids, amino acids, prohormones, and minerals, and they make up your biochemistry that has to have a certain kind of balance to it to keep things in place. And if there's an imbalance in your biochemistry and your microbiome, then antibodies get produced naturally, or you have been exposed to an antibody that then is searching and destroying, searching for a programmed antigen. And antigen can be programmed, and so can an antibody be programmed. And you can have secondary antibodies be programmed. So you're dealing with, like, the rabbit hole goes down deep, but I don't want it to sound too conspiracy related, but you're seeing a major, major agenda going on. And right now, we have so many people that are very politically motivated, politically minded. People in all levels of government, whether president to Congress to whatever, are making a lot of money off the manipulations of the population. And that's unfortunate to say. I mean, I want to give the benefit of the doubt to Trump. I want to give the benefit of the doubt to Fauci. I want to give the benefit of the doubt to anyone out there that's in the public eye. But money is what makes the world go round. And if you're not savvy to the agendas of capitalism, and you are full of cancer, disease, and chronic illness, and you have weaknesses and dependencies, you're not going to see the psychological operations that are going on. And so, this is the thing about looking for a savior, and that's kind of unfortunate with the thing with the Q, the thing with the Trump. I mean, you guys are seeing my memes that are saying, there's like, oh yeah, real doctors are saying that you don't have to wear a mask, just get the hydroxychloroquine. That's gonna be the thing. They're trying to keep it from you. The CDC and Fauci are trying to keep it from you. And I'm like, are you kidding me? They know exactly, all of you conspiracy people who are trying to figure out how to uncover the secrets of the system when it's all over freaking Facebook. There's no freaking secrets, okay? But it's a psychological operation. And it's priming you for really the end result, which is the vaccines. They are focusing, they as a system, Fauci and Trump and everybody up there in high levels of government that are attached to these drug companies are setting you up for the vaccine campaign, which has more monoclonal antibodies that are bioengineered to cause more interesting diversity in our society. So if they focus on the antibody therapies like hydroxychloroquine and then make it seem like it's like a hidden latest to greatest, and Trump promoted it for a minute, so all the Trump people are like, oh yes, hydroxychloroquine. You're being played. As much as I think Trump is great as far as his personality, he's tied in with the system too. Come on, you cannot be that blind to this psychological operation. When you think there's a savior, whether it's your priest, whether it's Jesus, whether it's a political candidate, if you are looking for them to save you, whether it's Q, You will be easily manipulated. And this reminds me back when earlier, when I first started rolling out the Jilly Juice and people were seeing the positive effects of it, they were getting the benefits. And one of my moderators, who I still very much respect, but it's unfortunate that we had to part ways, Kelly Harris. Remember her? Nice lady. I was on the phone with her a lot in the beginning, and I give her a lot of credit in a lot of ways for sticking around. But I know that she's part of the Yah world. I guess I don't know if it's Jehovah's Witness, but she was very concerned with how people were viewing me as far as a savior. She was seeing them going like, "Oh my God, Jillian, you know, you're so amazing, you're so this, you're so that," like as if they were falling into a God complex, projecting it towards me. And I'm like, I didn't see it like that because I was still doing my Jilly Juice stuff, and I wanted people to understand my information. I wanted them to listen to me, so I wasn't going to be too concerned about it. And so we parted ways, and she lessened the amount of salt, which would be basically undermining the whole protocol, but whatever. And I wished her well, and I hope she is following my information and reversing her issues. But that's when it's dangerous. When you are putting all of your eggs in somebody's basket, you don't question, and then you allow them to psychologically op you know, create a psychological operation on you and manipulate you into something. And that's why I keep my hands basically off of you guys. Like, I don't want to be your doctor. I don't want to be answering any questions. I don't want to be anyone's savior because, first of all, that's a lot of freaking work and a lot of responsibility. Second of all, this is not something that I can impose upon anyone. I can convince anybody because when you are dealing with a system that mitigates pain, that wants to basically destroy your evolution process, which is basically the pain regeneration process until, you know, you are finally at the level that you need to be, then there's no more pain. When you are being constantly groomed by the system to mitigate pain, me trying to convince someone that it's okay to feel pain is not an easy venture. So I keep my hands off and I don't answer questions really. I don't guide anyone. I tried to do that and then it bit me in the ass because then people weren't expecting a specific, you know, evolution process. They were reacting adversely as far as their understanding. They didn't get it. They mischaracterized me and then they started demonizing me and then whatever. So I just said, "No, I'm hands off. I've given you guys all the videos. I've given you the book here that has very basic information. And I have outlined what is part of your microbiome, which is the viruses, parasites, protozoa, proteins, fungus, and bacteria. And then you have a biochemistry of fatty acids, amino acids, prohormones, and minerals. And when you have an imbalance, then you have antibodies. And we are not trying to promote anything like prescription drugs. Any doctor you deal with, I don't care who they are, whether it's a holistic doctor or an allopathic doctor, all they know is antibody acquisition. All they know is every single cure that is antibiotic. I don't care what you call it. You can call it any special exotic name, but the foundation comes from inducing antibodies, anesthetizing you, immunizing you against evolution. So these memes about real doctors are saying that you don't have to wear a mask, but hey, pick the hydroxychloroquine. It's a psychological operation. If it comes from a doctor, that's all they're doing is inducing antibodies. They're just saving their own ass and charging you money for it. Not all the time do they charge you money, but there are but if they can get people to trust them that, oh yeah, I gave you a stay of execution, and when they are taking the hydroxychloroquines, when they're doing the vaccines, when they're getting all their prescription drugs and holistic remedies, they're gonna have obviously eventual issues. They're going right back to that same doctor going, "Hey, you cured me 5 years ago and now I have this issue." Not realizing that that cure 5 years ago actually led the way to their next issue. And so it becomes this continuous train of freaking money. It is a constant money train in the holistic, allopathic, the doctors out there that are trying to feel like they're on the side of you guys, but you know what? They've been trained by the system. And they've pigeonholed themselves to be in this place because they've given hundreds and thousands of dollars or being paid a shit ton of money. They have all this, you know, prestige in the community. They're being revered and honored and followed. And I'm seeing doctors on my Facebook that are like, "Oh yeah, I'm the shit," without saying they're the shit. And they're like, "Oh yeah, I've given up my life and I'm sacrificing my family for all of you guys. And everybody has to wear a mask." And oh my God, they are just on that guilt train and soapbox on how everyone should wear a mask, everyone should do this, do that, and they're just such minions for the system, and it's hard for me to even watch. And so watching you guys that say that you're awake and you're promoting hydroxychloroquine from real doctors, and you're supposed to be like against the system, against Big Pharma, and these doctors are like the major representation of Big Pharma. What the hell are you falling into? And that's why I'm saying, whenever you are promoting something that's antibiotic or antibody inducing and you feel people should die, you will fall for any kind of psychological operation. And I'm telling you, everything is known on Facebook. The system knows how to direct you and redirect you and psychologically manipulate you because you've given all your cards. All of you have given all your cards. So they know how to mess with you. You have to biochemically, well, you have to first realize that you're being manipulated by the system and by the doctors and by the politicians. And then once you realize that, then you have to realize that you have to change your biochemistry or you're going to fall into the same psychological operations, looking for another savior, looking for another hero. Okay, and you don't even look at yourself as anyone that is worth saving because you don't give yourself enough value. You're putting all your money in the holistic allopathic system. You're giving all your money to Trump and Fauci and all these different people who tout themselves to be authorities on, yeah, the death process. But hey, you want to die. You say it's okay to die. It's okay to die. So then you're gonna fall for every trick in the book. It's like, oh my God. And so now that I see, when I see all these different exotic diseases and I know, okay, well, you have a percentage of your body that's made up of viruses, parasites, protozoa, proteins, fungus, and bacteria, and then we fall into these epidemic stuff, and people are giving up their DNA to get tested for the COVID, get tested for everything, and they come out positive. Now they have an antibody, they have your genome, they have your DNA. They're going to go use that to create more monoclonal antibodies to then go and manipulate people's genomes and create designer babies or entertainment for TLC. I mean, I'm watching, or I saw a preview for another show where this woman is having like babies upon babies, like sextuplets, triplets. Like she's having so many babies that are like identical twins. I mean, it's insane. She's like a baby factory. And they're having a show about how she has like these 50 kids, and all of them are like different sets of twins and different sets of sextuplets and quintuplets and quints. And I'm like, the entertainment around manipulating your genome, there's a lot of money in it. People like to watch, like when you go to the circus, you go to the freak shows. That's exactly what's going on. It's like TV and the TLC and A&E and all the different stations are like going to the Barnum and Bailey's. Circus way back then with the different sideshows. It's so unfortunate, but that's the way of the world, okay? And you don't have and the thing is you can't stop it, but you can rise above it and not take part in it. Yeah, I watched the show, so really I'm supporting it, but I'm just like it's like holy crap when you actually see what's going on. It's disgusting, but then you're kind of strangely fascinated by how they are, messing with your genome to create these specific outcomes, and you feel bad for the people in these shows. Like My 600-pound Life and hoarding, these people are so miserable, but yet you can't help them because the system has created these types of compartmentalized, microbiomes. I mean, you have your microbiome of the academia where they are grooming people to be journalists. Like I was part of the Silicon Valley, where they're grooming college graduates to go take part in the system of science and medicine and engineering and computer science and journalism to then direct the people and I there's a girl in my high school class where she's like a year ahead of me. She's like a CNN anchor over there in Hong Kong. Very well coiffed, very beautiful, and very, very, very influential in guiding people into a specific direction. And of course CNN, you know what CNN's about. And so I came from a world of where they are grooming children to be these minions for the system. And then there's other areas like Ohio here where they're grooming kids to be factory workers, to be truck drivers, to be, whatever. And poverty is definitely, right now the name of the game. People are becoming poorer and poorer over here. And that's unfortunate. but it's because of health issues, okay? And then the government's lack of strategy to work with a diverse population. But what can you say when everyone wants to listen to Cleveland Clinic and Ohio State University and me challenging a doctor the other day, and then I blocked him because I really don't want to destroy the poor guy if he actually knew what he was doing. But that's the shit that we are dealing with. You can't stop it. It's going to be prevalent. And as we move forward into the New World Order and the, all of the crap, the jetsam and the flotsam are coming to surface, and you're seeing, oh gosh, the deviancies, the sexual deviancies, and all these different things, as we are upgrading and I don't know. As we are purging right now, what's going on, you're gonna see a lot of shit the next 10, 20, 30 years. And you're gonna see everything that biotech has been doing. You can see the major diversity that biotech has been doing, and it's gonna come to surface. You're not gonna like it, but you can't stop it. You gotta let it run its course. Don't get totally involved. Don't try to be an activist around it, because you can't stop it. Okay, much as I can stop you from promoting hydroxychloroquine as opposed to a mask. I mean, come on. Those that are doing J juice, you have to rise above this stuff. You must, because you get caught up in all of this stuff, you'll never take care of yourself. But I'm giving you guys an idea, a glimpse of what truly is going on. And so you understand that every single disease that you have is based upon the monoclonal antibodies just controlling your system and shaping you and morphing you based upon the intention of the industry. So at this point, just wanted to give you a heads up, but yeah. All right, have a good day. Bye.